Yes, good morning. Vice President Jonathan Miller, State of the Nation, ADGA Kodo. Election supervisors and really excited working with all the chapters, the brand new officials. So, congratulations to all of you who are here in the Bible. And they have a state of the Mexicans in the world. We can be able to do that. But they don't have a lot of money to do that. But they don't have a lot of money to do that. Dave Nishahaho Jesus, work ACNA, a state representative from to Winona. I don't think that a state senator James C. Pasha is just so it's really exciting to have these three representing the nation. James C. Pasha is also the acting director of the League of the House Chiefs, overseeing the Veterans Administration for Navajo Nation. Arizona, Chico. We have Hugh Smith, agency commander from Eastern Tech, or who is now the acting director for the veterans, so congratulations to all the Arizona staff. New Mexico, Chico, we have Senator Pinto, representative in their call.
Thank you. snow, the danger, the strangers of the great so in James, it's very offensive. The sort of danger is in the sea, guilt, and some of the colors. As President said to those who know me, I'll eat down our age. Dana, Annie, and Lina, A. Ajin, that the same Asian Hutta Ajin da Anishiki veterans Bahagandal, Indi A. Hutal. Kadi Hutal, Josh, that there was me, sir. No. Hanti Pelzin, the Ajisa. So Nikhe Kodo Hubert's Eastern Agency. Make that easy with the beginning of the question. It's not that, 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 that I'm just told I don't need. So many of you know out there that there was an audit on the veterans housing, and that audit is public record now, and it'll be going through the council. Veterans program, which was under a division of the Bureau of Management, Vice President, veterans program a lot more transparent and more efficient for our veterans out there. So the President, Vice President budget increase almost twofold. Our office so that we could be able to fix those problems and to build our work of the center. So the old program indicated that there was mismanagement, meaning that there was some account with a Home Depot for materials. People would just go over there, put the materials, really not having an account for. We have Don on Hubert from Houston, the veterans out there have been saying, well, it's the Veterans Act has been approved, but what we say is that it's been approved. We're mismanaged in a way. We're wanting to build more homes for our veterans. Catch up, first of all, I think that's our priority. So we're presenting and we're also to see what we can do with the council and then providing our services for all the veterans. So veterans, I know you're very concerned and you're upset. Our veterans audit is public and there's going to be a lot of veterans members throughout the Navajo Nation. So those deficiencies that can happen. The past program and how it was operated, but we a lot better than it was prior administration. So,
veterans out there, we're going to be catching up this year. Veterans, but it's part of that 4% veterans trust fund. We take 2% and hold it San Diego. When Yen came, they were overseeing that. Now that transferred over to the Veterans Administration. So, we know that Chris Smithson did a great job of commanding, and he's a veteran, and he knows the veterans. He's coming out of the Eastern Base 60 Veterans Group. Today we know that there's an emergency on most of us. It's very fast that we have to continue to be able to do this to be back on the day. There's a lot of snow out there, and so we will say to you, some of the chapters that the Torah mentions in Cove chapter, Jericho, on a low mountain chapter, Red Valley chapter, Rough Rock chapter, those chapters. The chapter, you guys all pass the declaration of emergency. That means that you can use the monies. That I set aside for using the budget being passed down, basically, in a big vessel. When you get to the emergency, at the chapter level, that vessel, the AI, the budget, the value, that releases those funds into the chapter. High-risk individual, and then getting through the money rates, Navajo Nation, I'm going to get this idea of some of those expenses for personnel. I don't know what to do in the world. There's no seat back to do the whole thing for the community to address the money rates. Especially during this time, check on your elders. Make sure they have enough firewood. Make sure they have enough water. I don't think that I think it's good at the hospital, but I told them to do it. We're signing this declaration of emergency. Maybe we can get maybe some of our travel workers to get out there. Elders and take them to their doctor's appointment, hospital, get their medication. So it is not in effect right now, this minute. The Navajo Nation wide declaration of emergency. Navajo Nation. And so, ADC, make sure you work with your local chapters. I don't have any officials on the ADC staff. You'll be in contact with our staff also. It's in what they were saying, Trinate Chuckle. And then our children, too. And then the elders, the Gilead, in triple O,
Thank you, President Kwai, Jonathan Nez, Vice President of the Navajo Nation. Well, Mr. President, we want to say thank you for your comments on our Navajo Nation Emergency Chapter Nation. So, you can't see it, but I heard it and I saw it with my own eyes that there are chapters out there where all the paperwork $1 million threshold. You know, we had to get $1 million worth of reimbursements document in place, and sometimes it was very difficult for the organization to do because of the new federal regulations indicate that $1 million to $250,000. So we need to keep those receipts and those earned businesses to go source receipts. Some of your chapters are going to be kicking the kicks and ask FEMA for this type of reimbursement. This is the Navajo National Declaration of Emergency. I mean, emergency, it's a mandate. But in order for any type of assistance to be available, we have to declare an emergency. So, some of the counties. Supervising our constructive families, just to do everything that we are working on to do as a listener. The counties are going to be. They're on their way. Maybe Sheriff Casey Clark got the helicopter on COVID with the weather. So we're hoping to be able to mobilize. Even though there's not much infrastructure development yet. Nature, Bishmas, and Bishra. Resolutions by Lunda Eleha. Ara Kudora leadership. Ara goes that Tanya said. Thank you on behalf of the Office of the President and Vice President for what you but infrastructure development and need require the host that you are. Senior citizens, senior I'm not going to be able to do that. just imagine what you could do to empower our people if they were to start planning that. We want to encourage you, our children to have to do that. I want to thank the Finance Youth Center, Shiriya, Japan, Zendo, Ajido, Head Start, so you don't hear that we didn't need all this person. So it's going to be a good night. This is 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 I'm going to go ahead and son of the wind of the Constitution.
They were going to give us only, they were going to give us 3,000 acres, feet per year.
This is our Vice President. lot of questions. How are you doing, Mr. Arnold? You're praying for the nation, praying for our leaders. We don't know what the future has. So here, God bless you, Mr.
Oh, here, last another call. Yeah, I don't know what you like for. Yes, I'll be attending meetings next week to see what we get this the funding list for. So we really appreciate the snow. We've been blessed with it. 18 and 10. God bless everyone. Thank you.